An update. My electric wheelchair is now completely unusable. From Daniel J. Towsey, May 12, 2012. I am now trapped in my home. I live alone and I have no relatives in this country. I will not be able to go out for anything. That includes groceries. I can walk short distances with a walker and my knee braces. But I cannot stand for more than a minute before the pain from my multiple skeletal injuries becomes unbearable. I cannot carry anything and I can barely hold on to my walker. I can travel in a taxi if it has armrests. But there is no grocery stores near me that have motorized shopping carts. Going to one far away that does is still not an option as they do not deliver and the taxi drivers refuse to carry my groceries up to my apartment. We have a public health care system here in Halifax, Nova Scotia. So they are supposed to provide and care for my wheelchair. The supervisor Tammy Hamilton, 902-424-1946, at Social Services says she will not authorize me getting the wheelchair I need. They also will not fix my broken motorized chair. So when I went to the welfare office to speak with her because she never answers her telephone nor returns calls for anyone, I was told that no one can come in off the street without an appointment. Appointments are done by telephone. But the supervisor never answers her phone, nor does she return messages. So then they called the police and told me I am banned for 6 months from going to the welfare office. If you have read my previous articles about my serious difficulties with the government abusing my rights, you would know how serious and difficult my situation is. You would also realize that the Nova Scotia government does not care for nor protect the rights of the disabled. Instead, they just get worse the more I try to remedy the difficulties. Here in Nova Scotia, wheelchairs are assigned by government occupational therapists. I have been dealing with Mark Burley at Nova Scotia Rehabilitation Services. He has not been willing to replace my chair with one that I need. Plus, the chair I have is constantly breaking as it is an indoor chair and I only use my chair outdoors. If you have read my previous 15-page report that I sent to Mark Burley, 902-473-7362, entitled, My Invacare Wheelchair is So Horrible, it can be read or you can hear the video transcript at wheelchairrights.wordpress.com, you would then realize how criminal the behavior of government and its agents has been. And you would fully understand why my chair needs to be replaced. Mark Burley has chosen not to read my report and has also chosen to ignore the quote from the Bounder wheelchair manufacturer, for the chair I need. It has now been 6 months since he received the quote that he has not assessed it. So now I have been getting really desperate and upset. So now Mark Burley insults me by saying that I should go see a psychiatrist. So now I am very worried as I cannot go out of my home and I am very much a prisoner. That is the way the government of Nova Scotia treats diaspora people. If you, my readers, are concerned, then please telephone our elected ministers below and express your concerns. Thank you. The Nova Scotia Minister of Health. 902-424-3377. The Nova Scotia Minister of Social Services. 902-424-4304. Also please note that I am still being denied any and all medical services. I cannot even get a family doctor as corrupt government insiders keep interfering with my life. A note about the wheelchair and why it cannot be used. The right side drive wheel is no longer in contact with the ground. It seems that the tire was spinning on the rim and then now the tire is not even touching the ground. The frame of the chair must be bent or broken. Also, the chair has numerous electrical and electronic problems. See pictures below.
Thank you for listening to this. And I hope that someone out there will make some phone calls and just express their concern, because I'm doing my very best to be reasonable with these people and they're just continuously mistreating me. Thank you again. Bye.